Hello everyone, today is December 12th. Welcome back to the channel. The title of this video is whether the PetroDollar will be replaced by PetroYuan. This is a hot topic today, especially after PRC President Xi Jinping's historical visit to Saudi Arabia last week. The answer to this question is simply yes or no, as I will explain later in this video. However, the key message is this is a wrong question to ask. Remember, asking the right question is more important than providing the right answer. In today's video, I will not only answer the question and also analyze what should be the right question to ask. Last week, during Xi's visit, he signed a comprehensive strategic partnership agreement with Saudi Arabia. Rumor has it, there was a bet between Bloomberg and the Wall Street Journal whether the PetroYuan will happen or not. Xi has already ended his trip to the Middle East. Do we have the winner of the bet yet? Neither the Arab news nor the Chinese news have any specific mention of an agreement if the crude oil imports will be paid in renminbi or not. This is a very sensitive issue, especially for the US at today. Before discussing further, we need to first understand what is petrodollar. It is not a currency. To different people, it means different things. I like this simple definition. Petrodollar is a word used with two distinct meanings, often confused. First is pricing of oil is in US dollar. Currencies used as a unit of account to price oil in the international market. And then oil-producing nations are paid in US dollars. Petrodollars are crude oil exports' revenues denominated in US dollars. Then as now, oil sales and the resulting current account surplus were denominated in dollars because the US dollar remains by far the most widely used currency. From 1970s, Saudi Arabia and the United States sent a long-standing agreement that requires Saudi Arabia to sell its oil only for US dollars and to hold its preserve partly in US treasuries, all in return for US security guarantees. It is widely believed that petrodollar system has helped preserve the dollar's status as the top global reserve currency and payment medium for oil and other commodities. The US dollar's global popularity does not depend on the goodwill of oil exporters. It is based on US status as the world's largest economy and goods importer with deep liquid capital markets backed by the rule of law as well as military power. To sum up, claims that the US dollar's primacy rest on its status as the settlement currency for oil exports have it backwards. The dollar's status as the global reserve currency is what keeps it indispensable to oil exporters. The dollar was the established global store of value decades before non-US crude oil exporters rose to prominence. The relationship between the petrodollar and the US dollar hegemony is like chicken and egg. As of today, 60% of the reserve currency is US dollar in the world. The scale of petrodollar is huge. Global crude oil exports averaged approximately 88.4 million barrels per day in 2020. That pace would generate annual global petrodollar supply of more than $3.2 trillion a year, assuming an average price of $100 per barrel. The conclusion, by the end of Xi's visit, there's no details as to whether the oil trade between Saudis and China will be nominated in yuan. So there is no petroyuan to replace petrodollar. In fact, I think majority people held the same opinion, that there would be no petroyuan, at least in the foreseeable future. Why? As agreed by many people, there are some intrinsic problems with petroyuan. All buyers of exported oil can easily access US dollars, while only China and most Chinese companies held the Chinese national currency, called the yuan or renminbi. Unlike the US dollars, the renminbi is not a freely convertible currency. Its exchange rate against other currencies, including the US dollars, continue to be managed by China's central bank. US dollars from crude exports can be easily invested worldwide, including the 13.4 trillion usual dollar markets for short-term dollar denominated deposits in European banks. Crude exports proceeds in Chinese currency cannot be invested outside of China as wide as USD, and can only be invested inside China at the discretion of the Chinese government. Why do people tend to ask whether that a PetroYuan would replace PetroDollar? The famous Thucydides trap describes that when a great power's position as hegemon is threatened by an emerging power, there is a significant likelihood of war between the two powers. China now has the second largest economy in the world and is working hard towards the number one. Chinese technology, aerospace, military, and global influence is also growing rapidly. On the other hand, US dollar dominance have been continuously weakening in the recent years. With globalization, more and more jobs have shifted abroad, and percentage of US economy towards global economy is continuously shrinking. Then comes the irresponsible monetary policies of US. Instead of working hard and produce more goods and services, feds are simply printing money and drop interest rate to zero. And the federal spending during the 3 years of pandemic goes to sky high. US current prosperity results from money printing instead of hard working, which eventually resulted the stubborn high inflation and the dumping of US treasury bonds around the globe. In the Ukraine-Russia war, US has used the US dollar hegemony not only as the currency, but as a weapon, such as kicking Russia banks out of SWIFT, freezing Russia overseas assets, etc. This sends the chilling effect to all countries to rethink their overseas investment and diversify their portfolio. Biden and the US government have already abandoned the Middle East and Saudi Arabia. There are three reasons behind that. First is the shale boom in US have removed the dependency on the oil-producing region. Secondly, the green energy movement untied the economic development to fossil fuels. Third reason is gradual shrinking of US influence and power that has been sucked out by the globalization. To many, US withdrawal from the Middle East is a natural and unavoidable process. But the Biden administration and all the strategists have forgot one thing. Saudi Arabia is de facto the Achilles heel of US. It is the source of the dollar hegemony, which started US global dominance. It may be the fatal spot where everything ends. To beat the old number one, you don't have to fight with it in its old way. To beat Google, the search engine giant, you can't beat it in the traditional search. To beat Apple, you can't beat it in the smartphone area. The newcomer has to invent and introduce a new game and become the game changer. China emerged as a game changer. It does not invade countries. It does not topple governments or build colonies, but its Belt and Road Initiative use the economic power and help third world country to build infrastructures, which is very hard to resist by the developing world. In the Arab news, the Crown Prince Ben Salman's 2030 vision has already been tightly woven with China's Belt and Road Initiative. Yuan probably is not the best way to replace the dollar, but the Shanghai Petroleum and Natural Gas Exchange platform will be fully utilized for yuan settlement in oil and gas trading. As I mentioned earlier, when does PetroYuan replace PetroDollar is the wrong question. The game has changed. Some believe it's already happening, but that neither China nor the Saudis want to highlight it publicly. The falling of PetroDollar would be three stages. The first stage is the start. It then enters the faster stage and gain momentum. The third stage is the big crash. We are already in the second stage. When we are standing on a melting iceberg and you can hear the cracking sound coming from underneath, it's just a matter of time for the ice cap to fall apart. To the bet of Bloomberg and Wall Street Journal, I don't think it even existed. As I have explained, this is not even the right bet to make. The absence of PetroYuan does not mean that China will not go into replace U.S. influence in Middle East. Thanks for listening. Since you are already here, if you think what I say is reasonable, please hit the subscribe button. There are more good videos to come.